2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Professor Clare Collins joining us again. Clare, today we're not going to talk about diabetes as such, but pre-diabetes, that state you're in before you get the full-blown diabetes.
Yeah, I thought it was really important because at pre-diabetes, it's not too late to turn the path back to having normal blood sugars. And in Australia at the moment, there's about 2 million people who have pre-diabetes and they don't even know.
That is, there's good and bad in that. The good news is that if you're there, you can do something around it. You can make a U-turn and head back to full health. But if you don't know that you've got, if you're not sure you're in that category, what do we need to do to shore ourselves up?
Well, if you're really not sure, talk to your GP because there is a diabetes screening calculator. And your diabetes can, your doctor can actually check your risk factors as well as some variables around, like your blood sugar levels. But there's actually five things that you can eat or drink in order to help you avoid developing type 2 diabetes that I think we should focus on today.
Let's have a look. Firstly, the foods. What are those nice foods that are going to help us out?
Well, first of all, let's talk about the ones that are easy to ditch, and that's soft drink. So a really interesting study.
Says you.
Yeah.
Easy to ditch.
Well,
yeah.
switch, you know, if you don't want to just drink water, then switch to the diet versions, because a really large study showed that over 10 years, for every extra can of soft drink you have per day, there was a 13% increase chance of developing type 2 diabetes. So just switch to the diet version. That's really, really easy. Or have a cup of coffee. So that's the good news story, is that it's come across a number of studies now, is that coffee actually lowers the risk of developing type 2 diabetes, and it both caffeinated and decaffeinated coffee. And the reason for that is there's two bioactive components in it called chlorogenic acid and caffeic acid, and they actually upregulate the pathways that allow your body to handle glucose in the blood and help your insulin to work better.
Which is great for most people around here. Everybody loves their coffee except me. I don't drink coffee either. I'm two for two, Claire.
Yeah.
Two for two.
Oh dear, let's see if we can help you with something. But let's talk about having more vegetables and fruit then, because these chlorogenic acid and caffeic acid, they're actually also in a lot of plant-based foods. So the chlorogenic acid, that's in things like prunes and plums and peaches. And the caffeic acid, that's actually in cinnamon. So if we move to plant-based diets, so that's vegetables, fruit, being a semi-vegetarian so that you eat beans and legumes, people who follow healthy plant-based diets, eat more of the healthy foods, they actually have a much lower risk of type 2 diabetes as well. And in fact, that was about a 34% lower risk. Yeah, so that includes whole grains, fruits, vegetables, nuts, legumes.
So eating the right stuff and more of the right stuff drops it by a third just like that.
Yeah, it's really easy. And in Australia, less than 7% of people eat the amount of vegetables and fruit that we know conveys good health. So when you're cooking your dinner, it's really important that you add a whole lot of extra vegetables. When you go to the supermarket at the moment, yesterday I bought, there's must be cabbage season because there's about 10 different varieties. So I bought red cabbage. So if you, rather than just cook chicken, chop up a whole bunch of veggies and make something like chicken chow mein.
Sounds pretty good, and some great cooking tips there as well, Claire. So anything else you need to be aware of as in terms of pre-diabetes?
Yes, it's really, really important, because lots of studies all around the world have shown that when people eat like we've just spoken, eat more vegetables, cut down on the processed foods, they drop 5 to 10% of weight and walk for about 30 minutes a day, that you can more than halve your risk of developing diabetes. Again, the big studies around the world have shown that all those strategies, if you are unlucky enough to still get it, it's delayed by at least 4 years. So they're easy changes to make, and they're absolutely well worth it, so that you're eating better and you're feeling better and you're preventing type 2 diabetes.
A little bit of exercise, ditch the stuff that's no good for us, and a lot more of the right food, and plenty of other health benefits as well, but particularly today in terms of combating that state of pre-diabetes. Thank you, Claire, for coming in with all of that information.
Pleasure.
We'll talk to you next time at 2NURFM 103.7.